Hi guys, this is Vitaly with AFT Dispatch and A2C Logistics, and in today's video, I'd like to speak with you about Deadhead Miles. Now, before we get started, I'd like to ask you to please like the video, be sure you subscribe to our channel, and hit the notification bell so you never miss a single release of our videos, where every Friday, we're talking about something that could benefit you in your trucking businesses, in your trucking careers, as well as cover the loads we've successfully booked for our customers, consisting of lease-out owner-operators and carriers operating under their own MC authorities, running under our truck dispatch services. As always, guys, I want to say big thank you for all the likes you provided on all the previous videos. Please do keep them coming, and let's get the show on the road. I want to talk with you about Deadhead Miles. Did you know that they're a trucker's best friend? Now, hear me out. Here's the thing. A lot of folks are, you know, adamant about not deadheading or deadheading as little as possible. And in a way, I do understand what you're saying. You're really trying to be as efficient and effective as possible. I get that. But here's the thing. A lot of folks would like to deadhead, you know, 10, 15 miles for the next load, and they just refuse to go any further than that. But the truth is that when you're running a whole week of miles, what you're going to generally find, at least running with us, you're only going to deadhead somewhere between 5 to 15% of your loaded miles will be deadhead miles. So it's really not a huge amount, and our dispatcher is always going to make sure that you're well paid for those miles. For example, You know, my brother, years and years ago, I actually booked this load myself, so I do remember, he deadheaded about 600 to 650 miles. It was a whole day's worth of work, and it paid so incredibly well that it made sense for him to go out there. The broker had a flexible schedule. He deadheaded for an entire day, went out there, picked up the load, and ended up going from a bad area to a good area. That was well done. Now, here's the thing. What's so bad about that? If you're deadheading, those are empty miles, which means that, guess what? You're much more fuel efficient. You're going to pay a lot less money on diesel. You're going to have a lot better fuel economy. Your truck and trailer are going to need a lot less maintenance. Your engine and your transmission are going to certainly thank you for it, because you're going to put a lot less stress on it. And generally speaking, the weather has been fantastic. There's no more snow. There's no more bad weather conditions out there. So you don't have to worry about your trailer being empty and wagging in the back of the truck over there, where it can cause problems in the wintertime, which I do understand. But we're not during that, that time of year at this point. So, you know, definitely be, you know, open-minded about that, because, you know, for example, if there are two loads out there, and this does happen, where there are two loads, they're going to similar areas, going to a good market, and one's paying say $5,000, another one's paying $6,000, except the $6,000 one's got 100 miles of deadhead, right? Or 150 miles of deadhead, whatever it may be. The truth is, who cares? You're going to go out there empty, you're going to get loaded, you're going to come back and do the same miles anyway. Those are paid miles. You got paid an extra $1,000 for those 100 miles. Consider that as 10 bucks a mile for your deadhead miles. Overall, your averages are going to, you know, improve, and you're going to go to a good market area anyway. It only makes sense to deadhead whenever the money's there and the load is well paid and you're going to a market area. And so guess what? Our dispatchers are always keeping this in mind. They will always take care of this, because it always makes me wonder, who the f*** are you to think that you can't be deadheading a little bit of miles? What kind of a f*** do you have to be? Well, who the f*** mother and who f*** made the decision to make the stupid f***? I mean, what the f*** are you thinking? Are you an Uber driver? Are you delivering some f***ing food? Are you a f***? What is wrong with you? Why can't you just simply take the load, deadhead the miles, and go out there and deliver the load? It's only good for you. It's good for your truck. What the is going on with your? I'm sorry. I'm gonna switch the camera. I'm gonna look over the loads we booked for our customers. See you guys in a moment.
Welcome back, guys. Let's take a look at some of these loads. I definitely hope you have enjoyed that last portion of the video as much as I enjoyed filming it. It was definitely a joke. Please take it as it is intended. And another great week for trucking in America. We're gonna start off with a reefer, and I will cover the deadhead miles, of course. Now, the video will be endless if I go through every single load, so I'm not gonna go through that, but I will tell you about the, you know, deadhead for the total for the week. Again, it's only between 5 to 15% of your total miles that you're gonna find in your deadhead. So realistically, it's totally worth it. We'll look through those as well. And of course, if you have any questions about any specific run or anything like that whatsoever, leave your comments in the comment section below. I will be sure to get back to you. So reefer coming out of St. Joseph, Missouri, going to Salem, Missouri. This was a 40,000 pound load of groceries at 60 degrees on the reefer. Now this driver started off in Omaha, Nebraska. So it was definitely worth it for him to deadhead out to St. Joseph, Missouri. It was 123 miles of deadhead. It was 302 loaded miles booked at $1,900. That got him $629 per mile. An excellent run. Then Granite City, Illinois to Cedar Falls, Iowa. This is a 42,000 pound load of dairy products. The receiver was in the middle of nowhere. And so we basically had two options, deadhead out to St. Louis, Missouri, or go to Kansas City, Missouri for a good reload. We did Granite City, Illinois to Cedar Falls, Iowa. 348 miles booked at 1550, got him $445 per mile. Then Des Moines, Iowa, going to St. Clair Shores, Michigan, 43,000 pound load of frozen meats at negative 10 on a reefer. This was a day and a half on the load, picked up in the morning, delivered next day at noon. 612 miles booked at $3,000, got him $490 a mile. Then Howell, Michigan, going to Cincinnati, Ohio, 40,000 pound load of dry food. It was, basically after 700 miles of driving on the previous day, he had 109 miles of deadhead on the previous one. So 700 mile day, a tough day. We ended up having to take a short little run for him for the available hours that he had left over. 280 loaded miles booked at $1,000, got him $357 a mile. Then took a load out of Hamilton, Ohio, going to Gaffney, South Carolina. This was a 44,000 pound load of frozen pizza, picked up late, and it was basically late pickup and late delivery at Nestle. 474 miles booked at $2,600, only 22 miles of deadhead on that one. Finished off the week with Mooresville, North Carolina, going to Perryville, Maryland. This was 43,700 pound load of bottled water, a dry load for this reefer. It was a Sunday load. Normally, we'd get a little bit more money, usually in the $2,000 range. This time we picked it up at $1,700 because there just really wasn't much freight available in the market, especially with the holidays and everything. So we had to come down a bit. Now it's 458 miles booked at $1,700. That got them $371 a mile, and ended up absolutely killing it. This was a reefer, ran Monday to Monday, ended up grossing $11,750 for the week, ran 2,474 loaded miles, only 503 miles of deadhead, and got an average of $475 a mile at 2,474 miles, and his average with deadhead included was at $395 per mile. So a very strong driver, this one, great attitude. That's the way we like it. We certainly appreciate the good attitude. We know things happen on the road. Sometimes it is the broker's fault, sometimes it's not, sometimes the shipper, sometimes the receiver, but it's your attitude that really makes it worth it. So great money, almost $12,000 in this reefer, excellent job. Next, we have dry van coming out of St. Joseph, Missouri, going to Milan, Illinois. 38,000 pound load of fertilizer and totes with a tanker endorsement from the driver. $1,300 booked on this one. 351 miles booked at $370 per mile. Then Burlington, Iowa, going to Grove City, Ohio. This was a 16,000 pound load of empty cans delivering at a brewery. A very light load, obviously. 481 miles booked at $1,800. That got him $374 a mile. Then Asheville, Ohio, going to Atkins, Virginia. 40,000 pound load of aluminum coils. Basically had to take a shorter run because they really took their time to unload at the last delivery. So this one was 291 miles, $1,500 booked, got them $515 per mile. Excellent rate. Then Princeton, West Virginia, going to Indianapolis, Indiana, 42,000 pound load of non-hazardous materials. This was a Friday delivery. 404 miles booked at $1,400, got them $347 per mile. And in Evansville, Indiana, going to Lakeland, Florida, this was a 43,000 pound load of flour. Ended up taking this load home. Took the load home after, delivering the previous load for the, Holy Friday right before Easter. There were not too many loads, again, options for a Friday. And so we ended up deadheading a little bit on Friday and picked up this load on Saturday with an additional $545 added on, more than the average market rate that was going. So we booked it at $3,045 for 844 miles booked at $361 per mile. Did an excellent job, regular van running Monday to Monday, ended up grossing $9,045 with 2,371 loaded miles, only 377 miles of deadhead, which got him $381 per loaded mile and $329 with deadhead included. Now this driver likes to stay, in a 400 mile per day runs, shorter runs, kind of in that area. Lives in Florida, but likes the Midwest market and the roads. And he was able to accomplish that, making over $9,000 with an excellent rate. Next, we have a dry van coming out of Sandston, Virginia, going to Terre Haute, Indiana. 35,000 pound load of dry goods. It's a little bit of a deadhead on this one, only 9 miles. Picked up in Virginia, moving back over to the Midwest. Easy load over the weekend, so you know he could do this reset. 712 loaded miles booked at $2,000, got him $281 a mile. Then Waseca, Illinois, going to Pleasant Hill, Iowa. This was 21,950 pound load of FAK. Again, a light load with a bit longer on the deadhead on this one, but a very good average. 365 loaded miles, 111 deadhead miles booked at $1,400, got him $384 per loaded mile. Carlisle, Iowa, going to Dahlgren, Illinois. This was 43.5 on a weight load of agricultural products. Again, moving back from Iowa, going south, quick loading and unloading on this one. And, you know, short deadhead to get that quick, you know, loading done. Only 9 miles of deadhead, 434 loaded miles booked at 1450, got them 334 a mile. Then Granite City, Illinois, going to Tomah, Wisconsin, 42.5 on a load. Moving back from south, going back to Illinois on another hot spot for a nice good reload. A little bit heavier on the weight, 42.5, but definitely good pay. 447 loaded miles booked at 1650, got them 369 per mile. Then we have a two pick one dropper out of Winona, Minnesota, and Burlington, Wisconsin, taking off to Columbus, Ohio. 44,234 pounds, a little bit heavier, moving from a hot area, staying in the, you know, Midwest overall, and definitely a great finish with 674 miles booked at $3,100, got him $460 a mile, killed it that week. It's a regular dry van, grossed $9,600 for the week, 2,632 loaded miles, 295 deadhead miles, got him an average of $365 per loaded mile, and with deadhead included, $328 in total miles. So excellent run, definitely a good week following the money and taking advantage of the market, staying in good market areas, and definitely taking the best pickings out there. Next, we have another van coming out of Dillon, Montana, going to Baytown, Texas. 44,000 pound load of bagged materials on pallets. Truck was located in Billings, Montana, so we ended up deadheading him over in order to take the better load. And from Billings to Dillon, Montana was 258 miles of deadhead, so quite a bit there. But, you know, it ended up working out good. Total loaded of 1,758 miles, booked at $4,300, got him $245 a mile. Then Houston, Texas, going to Texarkana, Texas. 43.4 on the way to miscellaneous goods. 290 miles, booked at $1,000, got him $345 a mile. Then Valiant, Oklahoma, going to Grand Rapids, Michigan. 40,000 pound load of paper goods. 986 miles, booked at $2,605, got him $264 a mile. And then Three Rivers, Michigan, going to Bennington, Nebraska. 25,000 pound load of porta potties, 597 miles booked at $1,900, got him 72 miles of deadhead, and that's $318 per loaded mile. Hopefully those porta potties were clean. $9,805 in gross income, 3,631 loaded miles, 444 deadhead miles, got him 270 per loaded mile, 240 with miles with deadhead included. You know, used to work for a week, you know, Friday to Friday, used up his hours, lots of miles, obviously 3,631 miles. Started with a really long run out of Montana, going to Baytown, Texas, with a bit of deadhead there, going to the west coast of Texas and Midwest, and definitely ended up with a very decent week for this dry van. Gonna finish off with a reefer, going to from Detroit, going with a one pick, two dropper to Sewanee, Georgia, and Newman, Georgia. And this was a 40,000 pound load of meat. They held us up at the shipper for one day, an extra day, and they also held us up at the receiver for an extra day. Unfortunately, the broker ended up vanishing on this load, so there was no compensation, but we're still trying and we're still working to reach them. And just so you guys know, we're always working for your layovers, for your for your detention, for any lumber receipts, anything that's owed to you, we're always working to get you that money. So one pick, two dropper, 40,000 pound load, 813 miles, booked at $2,400, got them $295 per mile. Then Lula, Georgia, going to Kenosha, Wisconsin, 42,000 pound load of frozen food. It was pre-cooled at 10,000, negative 10 continuous, 840 miles, booked at $2,000, got them $238 a mile. Then out of Milwaukee, Wisconsin, to Batesville, Mississippi, ended up taking good money because this was a tonu, truck order not used, product was not ready, but we got $250 for this one, and it was only 35 miles of Deadhead, so good money on that. Then DeForest, Wisconsin to only Illinois and Indianapolis, Indiana, so one pick, two dropper, 25,000 pound of groceries, and this was the same broker that tried to kind of make things up for the mess that they, you know, that they created in their previous load, ended up giving us a bit more money, 521 miles booked at $2,350. Got them $451 a mile with only 82 miles of Deadhead. Finished off the week with Hobart, Indiana, going to Paul's Valley, Oklahoma. This was a 35,000 pound load of frozen TV dinners. Delivery can be done a little bit earlier, and this gentleman is definitely an excellent driver, can make more money for the week if he's able to do that. Ended up grossing, so this one was $850, booked at $3,350, got him $394 a mile with 148 miles of Deadhead. Now, he ended up grossing $10,350, and that got him 3,024 loaded miles, 534 Deadhead miles, and 342 per loaded mile with 290 per mile with Deadhead included, with 537 Deadhead miles. And basically had extremely bad luck with shippers and receivers, at least, you know, half a day on each stop waiting, so that created some problems. Now, luckily, this is a very, very strong driver, and he can make up the time. He knows how to do it. He knows how to make it happen, because if not, he would have made half of his gross, and he was able to do it and made some excellent money, over $10,000 for a week, got an excellent rate, got his miles, and you know, basically took care of business. And again, guys, Deadhead is worth it to you. As you can see, you know, 5 to 15% of your miles will be Deadhead of your total miles. And so ultimately it's worth it to you, because at the rates that we're booking and at the way that we're hitting these markets, talking with these brokers and getting you these kind of, this kind of money, it's totally worth it to you to go the extra mile, you know, no pun intended, but go the extra mile, pick up the loads, because we're always going to make sure we're keeping this in mind. And if you want to make this kind of money, you certainly can, whether you're an MC authority, have your own MC authority, have company drivers, what have you, maybe you're, you know, have one truck in your company, you're the driver, it's fine. You have your own MC authority. We can dispatch you. We take care of the paperwork. We take care of billing and invoicing, your insurance. We do all the negotiations. We find you the best money, and we'll keep you running around like this until you're ready to go home. Now, if you're an owner operator and you're looking for a great lease on operation, we're a very honest company. We'll show you all the rate confirmations. Everything is very clear, very transparent. You get a weekly statement that shows everything and breaks everything down. Again, work with the same dispatchers, made great money, and we are one of the cheapest offers out there. If you want to get more information, more than welcome to call or text us at 801-448-6363. You can also get more information on our website at aftdispatch.com/go. On any one of our web pages, there's going to be a chat box that's going to kind of scroll through this through the bottom of the screen right now. It's on every one of our web pages. Just fill that out, ask you just a few questions. It'll provide us the information. We'll make sure to call you back, answer any and all questions that you may have. You can also go on our email list that also provides you more information. Needless to say, guys, the money's out there if you're working with the right company. So if you have any questions, call, text, email us, get in touch with us somehow. It's definitely going to be worth it to you. And don't forget, Deadhead Miles, your trucker's best friend. Until next week, guys, stay healthy, be wealthy. Take care.